Welcome or welcome back to my channel. Word problems can sometimes be challenging for some, but it's the math language that's used that can sometimes throw off what needs to be calculated. Let's get into it right now.
It's like every day.
All right, so let's get straight into the first one. 16 students in a chess club want to attend a tournament. The ticket price is $35 for each student, and the transportation and meals for everyone will cost $960. To pay for the trip, the students design a t-shirt to sell for a profit of $19 per shirt. If each student sells the same number of shirts, how many shirts must each student sell so that there will be enough money to pay for the entire cost of the trip? Okay, so first off, you'll notice that 16 is in words. Sometimes that's done deliberately to throw you off a little bit because the brain is not seeing a number. All right, so you make it a number, right? So that's the 16 students. Any other math in that first sentence? No, right? So there's just a number there. So the ticket price is $35 for each student. So $35 for each student, and there's 16 students. So that would be our first math calculation. So $35, and then we got 16 students. So 6 times 5, 30, 6, 3, 18, 19, 20, 21, 155, 133. Okay, 0, 6, 5. Okay, so we have 560, right? So that's the ticket price for everybody, and then the transportation and meals for everyone will cost 960. So then now we need to add up the ticket price, transportation, and meals for everybody, right? So we're gonna add this 560 to the 960. All right, I always like to put the biggest number on top, but it doesn't matter which way around you actually put it. All right, so that's a 0, that's 12, that's 9, 10, 15. All right, so we got 1,520. All right, so let's carry on. To pay for the trip, the students design a t-shirt to sell for a profit. So they want to make a profit of $19 per shirt, right? So then we want to say, so if they want to make a profit of $19 per shirt, we have to say 1520, and we have to divide that by the 19, right? So we got 1520, and we're going to divide that by 19, all right? So 19 into 152, all right? So 8. 18, okay, minus 15, 20, 20. Okay, all right, so 80 times 19 is 1520. So you got 80, but then if each student sells the same number of shirts, right, so we got 80 shirts, but if each student sells the same number of shirts and there's 16 students, then how much must they sell each shirt for, right? So the last part that we have to do, we have to divide 80 by 16, right? Okay, so we got 16 students and 5, that would go 5, yeah, 5 times, well, 5 times 16 is 80, isn't it? So there we have it. So this would be 5. So they'd have to sell 5 sweatshirts each, right? And that will give them their profit of $19. Let's go into this next one. So 3 students performed an experiment using iodized salt and a glass beaker. The beaker contained 530.2 grams of salt before the experiment began. During the experiment, each of the 3 students removed 47.36 grams of salt from the beaker. How much salt was left in the beaker at the end of the experiment? Okay, so here again, you can see they put 3 in words, so we need to make sure that our brain picks that up. So it's 3 students, and the beaker contained that much grams of salt before the experiment. Now, while they were doing the experiment, each of the 3 students, so remember, each always means multiplication, it never means add, it never means subtract. It always means multiplication or actually division, right? So each of the three students removed 47.3 grams of salt from the beaker. So if you have these three students removing this many, the best thing to do then is to do the 47.36 times three, because that would be the total from the three students, right? So we're gonna do 47.36, which is here, and we're gonna multiply that by the three students, because we need to know the total of that, of the three students, then we can do take that away from the total of the 530.2 grams before the experiment began. So we got 36, 18, 33, 9, 110, 37, 21, 22, and then 34, 12, 14. Okay, so we got 142.08. And that is the 47.3 grams of salt added together, right? So, and then now we're gonna take that away from the total that was in the beaker. So 530.2, and then we remove this from there, right? So 420.08. Now, because there's nothing here, you give it a zero value just to balance everything out. So then now you can take away. Okay, can't do that. That's a two, can't do that, can't do that. So we do this. All right, that gives an eight, that gives an eight, that gives a three. So we have, oh, one takeaway, nothing is still one. There we go. So we have 388.12 grams that was left in the beaker at the end of the experiment. This last question is really quick. Let's take a quick read. The dimensions of Mr. Aleem's bedroom are 10 feet by 18 feet by 8 feet, and the dimensions of his dining room are 14 feet by 20 feet by 8 feet. What is the total volume of the two rooms? So basically you need to answer this, and then add the two answers together. So the first one, his bedroom is 10 by 18 by 8. The good thing about the tens is that anything that's multiplied by 10, you just put a zero on it, right? So 10 times 18 is gonna give you the 18 with a zero on it, which is 180, right? And then 180 times 8 is going to give you 1440. Let me just show you. 180 times 8. So you just add the zero at the end. You would do 18, if you do 18 times 8, or if you know your times table like that, then you just tag a zero on it. But we're going to do it like this. 8008864, and then 8 times 1 is 8, and 6 is 14. So that will give us 1,440. And then the volume of this, so we got his dining room is 14 by 20 by 8. All right, and then we have, well, 20 times 8. If you do 2 times 8 is 16 plus 0, so that's 160. So this is 160. And then all you need to do then is 160 times the 14. It doesn't matter in which order you multiply. They're gonna give you the same answer anyway, whether it's 14 by 20 by 8 or 20 by 8 by 14, it doesn't matter. So at this point, we're gonna do 160 times 14, right? So 400, 6424, 414, 5, 6, 100, 166, 111. All right, so that gives us 2,240. And then what you do from here, because it says what's the total of the two rooms, you just add these two together. All right, so we're gonna do 2,240 and 1,440, and then that will give us the final answer. So we have 0,863. So we have 3,680 cubic feet, everyone, cubic feet. All right, because once you multiply volume, volume is three-dimensional, right? So cubic feet, volume of the two rooms, their feet, but cubic to the third power. So those were just a quick three examples of what word problems can look like. But I think if you imagine yourself in the actual word problem and decode the math language, I think that will be enough for you to calculate and solve the problem. Like, comment, and subscribe with that notification bell so you will know every time I upload, which is every Wednesday. And I will see you next time in another math video. Thank you for watching. Class dismissed.